My name is Ivan Vujkovic-Cvijn. I'm a graduate student in the biomedical sciences program here at UC San Francisco. And right now we're in one of my two labs. I'm actually co-mentored by two faculty here at UCSF. And this is the lab of Mike McCune at the San Francisco General Hospital. I'm studying HIV and how HIV may cause inflammation in the body. So HIV is a virus that attacks our immune system, and the way that it's thought to do this is actually by causing activation of the immune system, which is called inflammation. And it's this inflammation that's thought to lead to AIDS, which is a lethal condition. But the thing is, we don't fully understand all the ways that HIV is able to cause this inflammation. There's this really huge interest now in the microbiome, what's called the microbiome, which is the community of bacteria that live in and on us, though most of them live inside our gut. And it seems that when this community gets thrown out of whack, when it changes, it can cause a multitude of problems in the body, including inflammation. And HIV actually happens to specifically attack an immune cell in the gut that's responsible for making sure that microbiome, that community of bacteria, doesn't turn awry, doesn't turn into something that could be harmful for the body. And what we found is that the microbiome of HIV-infected people is very different from those of uninfected individuals, and that it may actually be contributing to this problem of constant inflammation in HIV-infected people, even on modern treatment. So I was born in Yugoslavia, in Belgrade. Yugoslavia doesn't exist anymore, it's now Serbia. My family's from there, and I lived there until I was 6 years old, and then my family came here to the United States. I was really into music as a kid. I played a couple instruments, and I thought that I would be a musician when I was a kid. But then in college, actually, I became really interested in science for a number of reasons, and also my dad is a scientist, so I think that maybe I was influenced by him a little bit. I'm proud of the research project that I've undertaken here at UCSF. It was largely independent. It was something that I came up with. It was my baby. It was like my brainchild. The idea that the microbiome can affect HIV/AIDS and the progression of disease. So one goal of mine is to create a drug, or at least contribute to research that does have an application in something that changes human health. So I thought that the microbiome would be a great opportunity to try and do that. Every day is completely different. If you don't like monotony, you'll love science. Even when we repeat an experiment, we're usually changing something about it. And the path to creating the experiment takes a lot of optimization, a lot of trial and error. It's always different. And you invariably, you do many, many different experiments. So every day, like I said, is a very new experience. There's so many different techniques available in science. And you end up using many of them to answer your question. One that we do in the lab is high-throughput sequencing of microbial communities. So in that process, for example, you're taking a sample. We work with human samples. We extract nucleic acids, DNA, which is the genetic code of life. And then we PCR amplify a specific region in that DNA that allows us to essentially fingerprint what bacteria are in that sample. And then that moves on to a whole other set of analyses that then things become more computational. We work with computers and a lot of certain software scripts and statistical analyses. And then we create figures from that. And there's a lot of creativity along that whole spectrum that we have to inject in all of our work. Particularly when we're thinking about how to analyze things, we have to constantly be creative. There are a lot of things that excite me about every day in the lab and about science in general. Tons of things. So I'll briefly summarize. One is working with other people is super fun. Everyone here is super nice and smart and creative, and it's a fantastic environment, I think. Also, what really motivates me a ton and really does contribute to my everyday excitement is the possibility of impacting health and, you know, through discovery. there's something really exhilarating about discovering something about how we work, about our biology. I'd like to create a therapeutic that positively impacts human health around the world. That's my goal. That's a lofty goal, of course, but I think that if I continue to work with other people, even if I can't personally achieve that goal, I might be able to help others or be part of the team that does so.